All right, guys, Papa Pepper up here in Wisconsin at the moment, and I found the same thing I found in Missouri and the same thing I found in Arkansas, which is Prep Sitter Bob. So while we were in the area, we exchanged some phone calls quick and decided, you know what, they were coming to the town I was in anyway. We decided to meet up for a minute, and here we are.
And he got taller since we last met.
We're on an angle. We got some little Peppers and Mrs. B playing back behind us here at tributary to the Wisconsin River. They're at home just enjoying that, so we figured we'd shoot a quick video and kind of dive into what is a prepsteader. Because when I first met Prepsteader Bob, I knew his name was Prepsteader Bob. I've known what a Bob is for some years now. And we met at the Baker Creek Heirloom Seed Company face-to-face for the first time. And they're actually one of the sponsors for the Self-Reliant Roadshow, which is so cool because they are one of my favorite, you know, seed company anyway.
They are awesome.
But to see them kind of back up these different initiatives where people take their time, tools, and talents, travel around blessing others, and just giving freely of what they have to set others up for better success and contribute to the well-being and livelihood of others, of just kind of getting them a leg up.
Yep, we enjoy it. We just finished with season one. We were down at your place, you know, kind of as we were starting off, and then just the 1st of July, we finished up season one. 4,500 miles as we traveled throughout the Midwest and made it back, and there's a lot of stories to tell.
Right, and then this fall, you're gonna start season two?
Yes, Lord willing, October 1st, Mrs. B and I will head out. We're headed over to New Hampshire and then drop down through the East Coast, and then we'll be down through the Gulf States trying to hit as many as we can. It looks like we'll be out somewhere between 6.5 and 7 months.
Wow, absolutely incredible. If you guys haven't checked out the Prepsteader Bob channel or the Self-Reliant Roadshow channel yet, please do. It's some amazing stuff. Definitely been it's been fun to just enjoy the adventure, you know, vicariously watching it happen, but I imagine actually doing it.
You know? Well, yeah, we got to know each other a lot, you know, from the Baker Creek Spring Planting Festival, from us stopping by your house, from you coming down and helping us with Bobblehead Homestead. I mean, it was just a huge blessing. It is one thing to see somebody on YouTube, and that's all edited behavior. Isn't it?
It is.
I mean, and for all of us, we all do that. But when you actually spend time with somebody and get to know them and see their kids, which Grandma B and I dearly love the kids, we get our grandma and grandpa fixed. But, you know, when you sit down and pray with somebody and break bread with them, then you get to know the heart of the individual. And that's why we love Papa Pepper and the all the Pepperheads.
Diving into this prepsteader thing, because I've known what kind of prepping is for a bit, I've known what homesteading is for a bit, I consider myself, you know, sort of a homesteader, but what exactly is a prepsteader? Where did that title come from? Why is it what you're known by, and what else do you want to say about it?
Well, we started off prepping back in the 90s. There was a lot of things going on. I saw some things that bothered me economically, the spirit and the shape and direction that our country was headed in. And so we were full bore preppers. Preppers, you know, basically is someone who understands or knows that we live in a dynamic environment instead of a static one, and that things change. You know, one phone call, one visit, one event changes the world as we know it.
Sure, and as an example, I just came up here for a funeral for my grandpa. He had 10 kids. In the past week here in central Wisconsin, 9 out of those 10 kids, out of their households, have been without power at one point or another, and some of them are still without power running off of generators. So it's a fragile world we live in.
And just being prepared for those events to soften the blow, to ease into the transition of what is coming or what is to be. And when we were prepping, I mean, we did the research, we did a lot of studying. I you know, for almost 60 years, I was raised on a farm, so there's just a lot of things that we did prepping. But as we were preppers, I began to see some of the fatal flaws in just being a prepper. The biggest one being logistics. You know, how do you get, I mean, yes, it's good to have your beans, bullets, and band-aids, but what happens when you run out? And so we actually, in early 2000s, started full-time homesteading or farmsteading. and we went full bore into that. And then the thing about homesteading is you basically want to do whatever you can to lead a simpler, self-sufficient lifestyle. But just like in any other movement, there are deficiencies in that as well. I'm not a pacifist. I believe that the things that God has endowed us with, we have a responsibility to take care of it, provide for it, for the security of it. So that's where prepsteading came from. I didn't coin the term. Actually, it came from Brad at Big Family Homestead. He wanted us to, we did a bunch of work with them behind the scenes, helping them when they moved to Wisconsin. And he's like, dude, we need to do an interview. It's like, dude, no we don't. I like living in the woods and living my life. But, you know, the hard reality is to whom much is given, much is required. And so we felt a burden to be able to go out and share our, well, like you said, our time, our tools, and our talents, going out and helping other homesteaders to, you know, learn to live a more simple, debt-free lifestyle.
Right, right. And that's even my push personally as a family into homesteading was as the earthly provider for yes. my family, I need to be a faithful, you know, steward and provider for my wife and my children. And there were certain things where I just didn't feel comfortable. If you're always reliant on somebody else for every last detail in your life, you're really not free.
No.
And you're really not prepared or set up to really handle any kind of glitch in the system. So I said, you know, we need to take a greater stewardship over so much stuff, including just our own food provision and a couple other things. So.
Yeah, and that's one of the things that we try to share through the roadshow is that I tell people we're there to honor God, family, and country. And we do that by sharing our experiences and sharing our time. Mrs. B and I live a very simple life. We live on less than $1,000 a month. Everything's, you know, God has provided and, you know, things are paid for, but that took a lot of work and effort. And right. so that's what we're trying to do as we're out, is to share with people how we accomplish that, show them ways that they can accomplish it on their homestead. And then, you know, there's always 1,001 projects.
Right, right, there really is. And as he even talked about behind the cost of living, you'll notice before, he talks about a simple debt-free lifestyle that is so close to my heart because yep. the borrower is slave to the lender, and so many people, you may think they have a nice car, you may think they have a nice house, you may think they have a nice PhD, but they don't own any of it yet.
They have a nice banker.
Yeah, they've got a nice, the bank's got some nice stuff, you know, that they let them live in for now, so.
But it's a huge blessing. We basically converted a school bus. We took $2,000, turned it into a motorhome. You got to see the inside of that.
Better than the one I used to live on. I used to live on a school bus.
Yeah, and it was great. We got to share that experience with you. And then we actually pull a trailer behind us with all of our tools in it so that we can pull into a homestead, you know, and then find out what projects they need done, find out what they can afford, you know, for buying materials, things along that line. Just jump in both barrels. So if you're not sure about what the Self-Reliant Roadshow is, we do have the whole entire first season on the Roadshow channel. It's called Season 1, and it's just, it was a, not only was it a blast to film, but it really did encourage us and filled up our hearts with joy because we didn't know how it's gonna turn out, but it ended up becoming a ministry of encouragement.
Sure, it was kind of the pilot, test drive, season of the whole thing, and I thought it worked out fantastic. I was glad to be a part of it as much as I was. Definitely looking forward to see what God accomplishes through them in the future. And I just think, you know, the community thing too, that's part of why we're trying to do what we're doing, even as the individual family, is a setup where we can take care of our own needs, but then also help others too. And even if it's just the inspiration of seeing, I was talking to a lady this morning and last night, and she was just blown away about the way that I think and apply myself to life. She says, this is what I need to hear. This is what I need to think about. And I think it's true. That's why it's what we do. So Prepsteader Bob, a combination of prepping and homesteading in a way that benefits both of them better. Thought up by Brad at Big Family Homestead.
Yeah, it's one of those things. Spend time with Brad very long, and after a while, his squirrels go crazy and things happen. So
right.
It's been a blessing.
Cool. So excellent to see you once again.
Yes,
guys,
always a blessing.
We went in the garden, and we went in the woods, and we dug out some food to keep these guys fueled up for their bodies when they pass through. So they just took us out to lunch at A&W Root Beer. Had a good time there, and I don't know, just had a wonderful day so far. We'll see what else happens, but just wanted to do a short video. Hope you guys appreciated it.
Hey, and just in closing really quick, if you haven't checked lately, for some reason, YouTube seems to be dropping subscribers. So go back through your subscribership, make sure you're subscribed to the different channels. If not, hit that button and subscribe, because this is a channel you need to watch on a regular basis.
Pop out.
As always, I'm Papa Pepper, and I'd like to remind you, don't post for free. If you'd like to be part of a revolution in social media, an economic power to the people where users can actually blog for cryptocurrency, then I'd recommend that you check out steemit.com and join the revolution. Papa out.